Well, thank you for joining us today on International Icons. I'm very happy to be featuring you.
Thank you so much for doing so.
So I find your career path a really fascinating one. You are one of the only Asian Americans to have risen in ranks to such a popular status in jazz music. Please tell us about your background a little bit. Are you of Indian descent?
Yeah, I'm sorry. You said please tell us, and then I lost you
Oh,
for
I'm
one
sorry.
second.
About your background a little bit. You're of Indian descent, is that right?
Yeah, I'm of Indian descent. I'm born and raised in Chicago, and basically I came to jazz because of primarily my family's love of the music and of music in general, and also kind of where I'm from in Chicago and the music scene there and just being around a lot and then, being encouraged to pursue it.
Right. So are you a first or second generation American?
Well, my parents were not born in the US, so I guess that makes me, I don't know what that makes me.
Okay, so now that's really still a very unique path. Can you tell us a little bit about your childhood and when music actually started becoming a really serious passion for you?
Sure. My childhood had a lot of trappings of kind of a typical childhood, but music was always around and in the mix. I think it kind of it became like a wider road with me as I got into school, and there were opportunities to play instruments and sing, and then it kind of became something that I, lost sleep over and tried to figure a way in by, early high school, and I think by middle of high school I was kind of set on doing what I'm doing.
Right. So when did you actually start singing? Was it in high school or prior?
Two, age two.
I'm sorry?
When I was two.
Oh, wow. Amazing. Okay. Was there a lot of influence within your own nuclear family? Was anybody a musician in the family?
No, but they have strong opinions and appreciation for art. So art in general was always part of our family, and music in particular was always on.
That's fascinating. So it sounds like you didn't actually grow up in a typical Indian or Asian family where the pressure is on to, do the typical career path of engineering or doctor or lawyer. So your family sounds like they really embraced the musician you.
I would say that's correct. Yeah.
Wow,
And I would
that's
also say
amazing.
that I can't say I didn't feel pressure from my parents. But I think it was not the kind of follow a path that we set on you without question. It was work hard, try to be good at what you do, but also remember the arts,
Wow. Can you tell us a little bit about what your parents do? It's a little bit unusual, to hear of Indian and Asian parents who have such an open mind about the arts. So I'm sure our viewers would be curious to know a little bit more about your family background.
Yeah, I don't mind. I mean, I'm not gonna reveal it too many deep dark secrets, but basically they're cool people. I think they are unusual on the spectrum of parenting in general. Maybe more so because, yeah, it breaks a little stereotypes of Indians, but I only learned that later. You understand? Like when I was young, it's just my crazy parents, and they are completely loco, but they one thing that they encourage me to do is ask a lot of questions, and the more I meet kids with strict parents, and a lot of Asian parents are strict, the more that that's not encouraged, and it came back to bit them in the ass when they said, well, couldn't you be doing something else with your life?
Mm-hmm.
And I said, you know, I've been asking a lot of questions of myself and those around me. You know, frankly, music makes the most sense spiritually and otherwise, then why shouldn't I do it? So I kind of asked them a lot of questions, and they realized they had raised a little monster, and they accepted it.
Well, when was it that you realized that music is really what you want to do with the rest of your life?
Like I said, like high school.
High school, okay. So when you went on to the University of Michigan, Ann Arbor, is that right?
Yep.
Did you study music there?
I did.
So then your parents obviously at that point knew all about it. What was their reaction, you know, from high school to college as you started embarking on this journey? What was their reaction to all of it?
Well, it depends on what mood you catch them in, you know, like, my parents are more than just parents, you know, like it's not a binary relationship.
Mm-hmm.
And my parents are friends, and my parents are people who appreciate art.
Mm-hmm.
And so the parents and my parents would say the thing that most typical parents do,
mm-hmm.
you know, like I'm concerned for my son's welfare and,
right.
you know, I want him to do better than I did. And, you know, if he's not making $1 million a minute, something's wrong with the world. But my parents are also my friends, and they understand the passions that move me. And my parents are also appreciators of art, and they wouldn't let me do some bullshit and get away with it, right?
Yes.
So I've gotten to a point, I mean, I was never really at this point, but it's not really, for me, ever been about whether my parents accept me or scold me, because I just don't have that relationship with them. It's really about, am I doing something artistic that would make them satisfied as consumers of art? So for me, the dialogue might have been a little hard when I was in my teens, for all the reasons that you're pointing towards. But we quickly moved past that because you know, my parents know how to accept things about me just as I accept things about the world, you know.
Right. That's a beautiful statement you made, though. That's also very rare, that your parents are not just your parents and they're your friends. That is a really unique situation. That's beautiful.
Yeah.
So what's next on the docket for you? You've had 3 albums already, and I believe you have another one coming out shortly. Is that right?
Yeah, in March, and I'm really excited to share it with the world.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell us a little bit about the arc that your music has taken from the first album and what we're going to expect from you coming up with the next album, the fourth one?
I'd love to answer that. I have been raised in a kind of a traditional jazz background, both through especially through my schooling, and I embrace that so wholeheartedly. And and on my first record, I wanted to showcase some of that love because it was the first time people were hearing me. And, you know, I had been living with that passion for my life.
Mm-hmm.
I want to share that. And as the records have evolved, there's been that dedication to showcasing how the tradition kind of moves along a little bit. There's also been some of my own writing,
mm-hmm.
which is important to have always been done. And now we're getting to a point where my own writing is featured on this new record. It's all my own writing, actually.
Oh, wow.
And
so
and
no covers
so
on this coming album?
Just one cover,
mm-hmm.
actually, or one or two covers.
Mm-hmm.
But basically, it's my own writing, and it's the writing has evolved into a style as well, and I'm excited for people to hear that style because it's evolved as I've evolved with
mm-hmm.
musical influences and neighborhoods and the types of cars I've been in and the types of, you know, planes
mm-hmm.
I've been in and the types of wrong turns I've made. And so we've kind of happened upon our own little fun project, you know, that I think folks will enjoy because it's not only good music, but I think it's uplifting music. and it's positive music, and so I think I begin to focus on that stuff when I share my writing with.
Right. So you mentioned just now about the difficulties, right, that you've gone through. Can you share with us what you feel are some of those key moments in your past that were very difficult, especially in your career path?
Yeah, I mean, the career path is not, the career path and life, it all kind of molds together. One thing, depending on how you look at life, things, all the dominoes can be falling down. I choose to look at my life like an opportunity to take the moments that I'm given on this earth and create something. Now, I go through, just like everybody on this planet, share of dark days and my share of dark moments. But when I set out to make this record, I was really excited about bringing a kind of joy, a kind of, head bopping, good time, joy that celebrates life, which includes love, which includes failed journeys, which includes your troubles, but really allows you to just enjoy some music and at least for a time be lifted. So that's kind of what this project was about. And as it relates to my own life, that's kind of where my life is too.
Right. But are there any specific key moments that you felt, maybe within the last 5 years specifically, that, were obstacles or difficulties or tragedies, what have you, that really molded, who you are today?
I had a pretty rough breakup a couple years ago, and that was a situation with a long-term kind of almost married type thing, and I was on a precipice of like, how do you make it work? And you try to make it work, and then it doesn't work, and you kind of go at it any number of ways to Sunday. And I realized that I had been writing a couple of my originals on the earlier record is kind of like a, this is unrequited and I'm upset about it. And, kind of having a messy breakup that lingers for a while and allows you to write a lot of songs about unrequited love. And then you're like, I could really just, wallow in a lot of pity, but I bet there's a lot of people that are going through some harder things. And I know that when I'm dancing in a particular night at a particular club to some uplifting music, I'm not thinking about like how bad my heart is breaking. I'm just having fun. And so I kind of set out in a way to make a record that might make you feel like whatever your particular issues are with your family or your loved ones or love or violence or health, this will just allow you to take a breath. And it's not idiotic, but it's respite,
Well, we all need a breath every now and then. That's great. So, are you touring constantly these days, or are you working mostly on the album right now?
It goes in flows right now, and I think right now a lot of the focus is on the record. So I'm home in New York. I go out, I mean, I'll be in Mexico next week, and I'm still touring, and but then we're going to focus on setting up this record in November, and then periodically until the record comes out, and then beyond.
Right. Now, whether you realize this or not, you're probably already, and certainly growing to be ever more so, a huge inspiration to particularly Indians and Asians, well, particularly in America, but around the world as well, who would like to follow in your footsteps, if not in jazz, in music and in entertainment. And you're going on a path of success that has, you know, is very limited for Asians in general, especially in America. So you are an inspiration to a huge population, and I'm curious to hear what advice you might have for some of those people of those demographics who look at your success and hope to follow in your path.
Oh, that's so sweet to hear, and I say thank you with all of me. I appreciate that those accolades. I'm not so great with advice, but I will say that people, they need to, when you're scanning through yourself and you're looking for your own personal reason for being, or the things that inspire you, and kind of matching them against your own skills or your own passions, your own talents. And maybe in your life you've kind of twisted those ideas and you found something that hits, you found that sticks. And when you are going to bed at night, you can't stop thinking or practicing or thinking about it or crafting it. And I think that actually needs to be nurtured, and everyone can nurture it in different ways. And like I said, I'm not good at prescribing particular advice, but the thing I would say is nurture it in a way that makes sense to you, and that's your own personal joy, and joy is to be. We need a lot of joy.
Right. So, going along the same lines and giving advice, what about breaking into the industry specifically? How did you manage to get your first record deal?
Well, I mean, my own story, I suppose, is as unique as any other artist, but the one thing that I would say is pretty similar is that New York is a big part of my story, moving here and being open to what it has to offer and being ready and flexible. I think that's the other thing, that I think flexibility, I think New York and just the industry in general is always throwing you little curveballs, and some of those curveballs are bad, and some of them are opportunities. And so you kind of have to be willing to sidestep things, or willing to, like, maybe change your opinion, or just be open, like, be solid on what you're solid on, and then be open on the rest.
That's
So
fantastic
I tend to
advice.
be a pretty flexible person, because I kind of need to be a little bit agile,
Sure.
it's not it's I know no industry is, but this one is completely in flux all the time. And I'm not talking about in a big way, also, that's well publicized, but in a small way, your plans are changing, the people that like you are changing, the people that dislike you are changing, the people that are giving you this or that opportunity are changing. And I think it requires a certain thick skin and a certain flexibility to kind of keep up.
So I've heard a lot of your music, and I personally love your voice. I think you've got a very round tone and a very smooth voice. It's kind of to me, a blend of Sinatra and Nat King Cole.
Wow.
Now, for those who are not so familiar with the music industry and the entertainment industry, can you share with us whether race has ever been an issue in your climb towards success in the music industry? Whether you've ever felt any pressure or issues or any discrimination. I mean, you don't need to go into details. I know, the industry is a little difficult. But have you felt any kind of issues about that, especially being in jazz?
I think the easy answer is no. I personally haven't. But talk to all the people that maybe bought my record because I'm Indian, or maybe the many more people who didn't buy my record because my name was confusing. I don't really know. You know, I haven't felt any direct pressure or direct racism, thank God, because I know so many people have. But I will say that race comes up quickly. And I will say that race plays an issue in a subtle way in a lot of decisions that people are making about who to listen to and who to buy and stuff like that. And so the good news is, I would say, and this is not really about me, but I would say we're not we're not holding to the worst of our racist personalities, but I think there are decisions that are made on race, and they're so subtle that for me to try to get in the psychology of every individual would be hard. You know, I just I think with such kind of macro concerns like that, you just say, well, I'm gonna sing as best I can and share as much of my soul, honestly, the joy I was speaking about before, and then hope that, you know, the barriers to the entry of your spirit and my spirit slowly get melted away.
Right, right. What's your ultimate goal? What's the biggest dream in life?
I'll tell you what the dream is right now with this record is to be on a stage, however big, however small, and have people in the audience singing the lyrics back to me.
Because
the music has been with them and they've enjoyed the songs and they've found an anthemic to their own life, and then they come to see me sing and we're all part of this moment together that feels like a bunch of individual journeys just meeting for one moment of magic at a show. That is the dream. I can't express that enough. And
that's
so
a beautiful
it's really
dream.
Not about the num yeah, mm-hmm. it's really not about the numbers or I mean I would be happy if that was 30 people in a club, you know. I love that. I love the idea that maybe this record will get to you and it will affect you in a personal way and you'll be lifted by it. And my evidence of that will not be through record sales or royalty checks, but seeing you at a show, singing the words back to me, that is a dream.
Well, that's a beautiful dream, and that's a perfect note to end this on. So the album is dropping in March, you said, right? Perfect. And it'll be on Amazon and stores worldwide?
Yeah. It's going to be on the Sony label, and they're taking care of me. So I'm hoping that with folks like yourself and just and the accessibility people that you reach out to with your readership will be able to get it easily.
Certainly. What's the name of the album again, please?
Honestly, we haven't figured a title, but it'll be my name. So
okay.
I can look out for that.
Perfect. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for joining us today and sharing some of your deeper thoughts with us on your journey.
Cool. I appreciate you taking the time.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.